Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Wednesday, February 8. We're now looking at a live view inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team here has been monitoring the systems aboard the station and supporting the day's activities of the Expedition 30 crew members. Flight Director Ron Spencer is leading the Orbit 2 team seen here in the Station Flight Control Room today. They're in the blue shirt on the right-hand side with Lucia McCullough there next to him on the left serving as CAPCOM. She is responsible for relaying all ground messages up to the crew. On orbit, the six crew members well into their busy work day aboard the station include NASA astronaut and commander of the complex, Dan Burbank, and flight engineers and cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin there on the left-hand side, as well as NASA astronaut Don Pettit, cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko, and European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers there on the right. Commander Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin launched to the orbiting complex aboard the Soyuz spacecraft as the Expedition 29 crew last November. They docked to the Poisk module of the space station a few days after their launch on November 16. Burbank then assumed command of the station only a week after they arrived. Today, he and his crew members complete their 88th consecutive day in space and have reached the halfway mark of their stay aboard the space station with a return to Earth later this spring on April 30th. Meanwhile, Pettit, Kononenko, and Kuipers launched aboard Soyuz TMA-03M from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan on December 21st when they began their two-day chase on orbit to catch up to the International Space Station. With their Soyuz now docked to the Rosviat module, they will complete their 50th consecutive day in space today. The space station with its crew aboard is now flying at an altitude of about 240 statute miles. The orbiting facility is making a northeastern track across the South Atlantic Ocean for a pass across Africa. Now in the middle of week 11 of its mission, the Expedition 30 crew continues to tend to a variety of science experiments that take advantage of the microgravity environment, perform regular maintenance to their orbital home, and also continue preparations for next week's spacewalk outside the complex. Today, Station Commander Dan Burbank is working with a science experiment known as Binary Colloidal Alloy Test, or BCAT-6, that looks at how gas and liquid separate and come together in microgravity. This study could lead to the development of better, less expensive household products, food, and medicine. Flight engineer Don Pettit will lend a hand in this experiment after putting away equipment used for an earlier session of the VO2 max study that measures a crew member's aerobic capacity during spaceflight. And Burbank and Pettit also conducted additional testing of the COTS UHF communication unit that will serve as a key rendezvous tool to help with the maiden capture and berthing of the SpaceX Dragon spacecraft once it is launched. Meanwhile, in the Russian side of the house, Anton Shkaplerov is busy replacing a few smoke detectors in the Rosviat module, while Anatoly Ivanishin tends to Earth observation photography for long-term geophysics research known as Uragan. Commander Burbank and Don Pettit took some time out just before today's update hour to answer YouTube questions from the public. The pair answered questions like how a helium-filled balloon floats in space and on Earth observations of the planet's natural changes. Pettit also earlier talked with high school students at Inuksuk High School in Canada via ham radio. Earlier this morning, aboard the International Space Station, Commander Burbank and Andrei Kuipers collected blood and urine samples as part of the sodium loading and microgravity study that looks at fluid and salt retention in the body during spaceflight. Kuipers also participated in the Lego brick study that demonstrates challenges in building things in the microgravity environment of space, while Pettit spent much of his morning setting up for and assessing his personal aerobic capacity for the VO2 max study. Anton Shkaplerov and Oleg Kononenko continue their preparations for next week's spacewalk on February 16. The pair were busy working with the Russian Orlan spacesuits they will wear for the 5.5-hour excursion outside the complex. The duo spent some time adjusting the height of their spacesuits and performed a leak check and valve test to the suit's interface unit. Commander Burbank, with his five crew members, also participated in an onboard training exercise to review a new respirator purge technique of the onboard emergency mask. Shown here, the crew is undergoing that training drill. The crew periodically undergoes onboard training drills to stay current on safety measures in the event a real emergency should occur and those emergency masks be needed. Later today, Commander Burbank and Andre Kuipers will collect additional samples for the ongoing fluid and water retention study. Burbank and Pettit will spend some time on entries to their individual journal study. The commander also will participate in an inventory management systems conference with the ground. At the day's end, each crew member will have participated in his daily two-hour exercise to maintain physical fitness and mitigate the weakening of muscle and bone loss that is experienced during long-duration spaceflight. The Expedition 30 crew will then participate in its final daily planning conference with ground controllers around the world to prepare for another day of busy activity before entering its pre-sleep period. The crew is then scheduled to go to bed at 3:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.